Concerns are raised over potential fare increases and a scarcity of jeepney units. Once Philippine transport regulators crack down on unconsolidated jeepneys. But it's business as usual for now as jeepney drivers ply their
drivers and operators still plying their usual routes across Metro Manila 2 days after the consolidation deadline. Commuters say they were able to go to work on the first workday of the year without much hassle. Jonah, who catches a ride daily from Cubao, expects a harder time after January 31st or after the one-month extension granted to individual jeepney operators to make trips and select routes.
Kumbaga, magsisiksikan pa yung mga commuter dun sa mga ibang ruta ng jeep, kaya mas matagal po yung ganun.
According to the LTFRB, unconsolidated jeepneys may only ply routes where less than 60% of PUV units have consolidated or none at all. But since the LTFRB has yet to release that list of routes, drivers believe everywhere is fair game. Even traffic enforcers have yet to flag Colorum jeepneys. Based on the Office of Transportation Cooperative's estimates, only 40% of PUVs in Metro Manila have consolidated.
One of the solutions the LTFRB is looking at to address the transport gap is to give special permits to consolidated transport entities so they can ply affected routes on top of their own.
But Transport Group Manibela and at least one operator warn this could stir up some trouble.
Pagkakaroon ng tension ito, pagka nabalitaan po na may pumasok niya, sana wag naman mangyari. Sigurado po ako haharangin yan.
Siyempre, pag nagkaroon ng harang yan, magkakaroon ng gulo. Maaring may madisgrasya. Diba? Kasi ano na yan eh, ang pinag-uusapan dyan, hindi na yung, ano eh, yung ikabubuhay na ng pamilya eh.
The OTC meanwhile assures PUV drivers they can still join existing cooperatives or corporations to sustain their livelihood. While some drivers are in favor of that, others are worried they will no longer be hired as they are already senior citizens.
Kung pwede, ganun lang gagawin namin para may hanap buhay pa. Kasi kung sakasakaling matigil yung basada ko, wala. Yung anak ko matitigil sa pag-aaral.
Tambay na to dahil gawa na sa akin, ang mga senior, wala na kami pag-asa.
But the agency allayed fears of that as well.
Sa ngayon po, may mga drivers po sa cooperative na nasa 65 or 70 o lagpas pa po. Walang pinipili yung edad as long as you are qualified. Meron kang professional driver's license, nakakapasa kang medical.
Meanwhile, commuters are worried about possible fare increases for modernized jeepneys. An economic think tank has warned minimum jeepney fares may rise up to 50 pesos in 5 years due to the government's PUV modernization program.
Our model is what happened with water privatization. Water rates were kept low for a couple of years, then they started jumping up after about 3 to 5 years. We expect that same kind of dynamic right now. Fares will be kept low at maybe 15, 20 pesos, 25 pesos, maybe for the first 3 to 5 years. But we fully expect in 5 years or more, it will hit about 45 to 50 pesos.
But Elvira Medina, chairperson of the National Center for Commuter Safety and Protection, doubts this.
Ang amin pong covenant is status quo. Hindi po kami ang mapagsamantalang katulad ng gusto niyang ipaharap sa publiko. Hindi po kami ang Magnificent Seven po ay hindi mapagsamantala. At alam po namin ang tamang siyentipiko na basihan ng ating pamasahe. Kasama po namin ang mga ibang siyentipiko katulad ng mga UPNCTF at iba pa pong mga ibang nag-aaral tungkol dito. Hindi ko po alam kung saan nila binasi yung kanilang mga statement na yan.
The Transportation Department earlier said all fare hike petitions by consolidated entities will still have to be studied and approved by regulators. Andrea Taguines, ABS-CBN News.
Firecracker-related injuries during New Year festivities in the Philippines rise to 443. The Philippine Health Department recorded over 200 new firecracker-related injuries. It also confirmed the first fatality from a fireworks blast. The victim was a 38-year-old man who reportedly lit a cigarette near a pile of firecrackers. Up next, communities evacuated from the northern area of the Gaza Strip may soon be allowed to return home.
More stories when the World Tonight returns.
Tinesting. Sinuri. Siniyasan. Ang resulta? Super effective ang Shield sa pagpatay ng bakterya at virus. Shield Antibacterial Soap. Believe ang mga eksperto sa Philippine Nurses Association. At si Mami.
Tiwala ako sa Shield.
Shield Antibacterial Soap. Napatunayang mabisa. Ang mga nurse, tiwala. ACS.
Tanggaling-galing mo. Smart dishwashing paste ko. Pritong ulam na masebo. Lalo ng kaldero. Tanggaling for everyday.
Ganyan pag smart ang dishwashing paste. May double tanggaling formula. Tanggal ang sebo. Tanggal ang bakterya.
Pahit para walang pahit. Inis fantastic sa metal at plastic. Number one ko to.
Tanggaling-galing mo.
Smart dishwashing paste. ACS.
The thriving space in fintech will further grow because of the support coming from government. We will be able to fulfill the twin goals set by the Digital Payments Transformation Roadmap for all stakeholders, for all players in the industry to convert at least 50% of retail financial transactions to digital and onboarding 70% of adult Filipinos to have transactional accounts by end of this year. The next goal is now on how we can ensure that we can really deliver the number